Hi, welcome to my biology class. Today let's go with outline classification of animal kingdom. This is Animalia. It starts from the kingdom and it is divided into two subkingdom, Parazoans and Eumetazoans. That is, Eumetazoa, true tissue graded animals, and here the number of cell increased but loosely placed. There is no any tissue formation. So the porifera, only one phylum. Under this you have 10 phylums. It's all the animals from Coelenterata to Mammalia with tissue grade, organ grade, organ system grade, everything is there here. And here when you talk about, again further classifications goes on like this, Coelenterata and Ctenophora, you have radial symmetry in their body. That is, out of 10 phylums, these two have got a radial symmetry. All the other, see, from Platyhelminthes to Chordata, there are bilaterally symmetrical. But still, this Echinodermata, the body is radially symmetrical. In spite of having a primitive symmetry, it is placed here. The reason is it is enterochilomate. It seems that the anus develops first in embryonic origin. We'll see. And when you come down to this bilateral symmetry, again the primitive kind of aeschylomate, Platyhelminthes, and then pseudoschylomate, Aeschylomanthes, and then eusilomate from Annelida to Mammalia. It is true chelome. The body cavity is formed. That body cavity that is present from the center tube to the outer tube, the coelom, wherein all the visceral organs have been placed. So it's a kind of a coelomic fluid where it'll be making this visceral organs safely placed in that region. And from here you see Annelida, Arthropoda and Mollusca, Schizoschelomates, that is in embryonic origin, they have mouth development first from the blastopore. Here Enterochelomate, anus development occurs first from the blastopore. So this is advanced. So when you talk about the chordates, here chordate phylum has got three subphylums, Urochordata, Cephalochordata and Vertebrata. Chordate in the sense endoskeleton, and here you see they're all invertebrates, only you can see the exoskeletal system here. Here in Urochordata, the animals are fixed, sessile, but their digestive tract will have a U-shaped structure. And Cephalochordata, cephalum, head is prominently seen, and the notochord is continuous in their body. But here when you come down to this vertebrata, the notochord continuous as, that is, it is replaced by vertebral column. So once the vertebral column means what, that there will be a cranium, the formation of a cranium, and the brain, the well developed brain is placed inside the cranial box. See, this is the brain, for example, I just draw, this is the brain, and this continuous as a spinal cord, and this is the cranial box continuous as a vertebral column like this. So once the brain is on the top of your body, this is the master controller of your body, which is controlling the entire organ system and coordinating with all the systems in your body. So the most important thing for the brain is a continuous supply of oxygen. For that, the animal should eat well. So when the animal has to eat well means its mouth part should be well developed. Mouth parts should be well developed in the sense, here on that basis they again classified Agnatha and Gnathostomata. That is, this is the animal without jaw and this is the animals with jaw. And here Agnatha, they are the cyclostomates. See, this class is very lazy animals because the mouth is without jaw. And sometimes it has got some small tentacle, like it's sucking, it has got a sucking type of a mouth. But when it comes, they chew the food, they eat the food well, so that the body is also a good size, and the brain supplies energy and controls the entire body too. So So from here, it is again divided into two category on the basis of their locomotory organ. And here, the pisces and tetrapods. Pisces, it's a super class it is. Actually, the pisces has got fins. So all the animals in this category has got fins, and they cannot walk, they just swim. In this Placoderma, the first class, is completely extinct, all are fossil. And Chondrioptes, and this is the cartilaginous fishes, like a shark. And Osteoptes, true bony fishes. This is an advanced one. When you come down to this, tetrapods, four legs are there. So the animals, this up till this is water, so they are all aquatic, and from here it starts moving from water to land. So it is wobbling between water and land, so it is an amphibian. And then from here, a fully terrestrial, only one or two category moves towards water, so they are all reptilians. Then apes, it starts flying, and mammalia. So the mammary gland is present, ear lobe is present, and they give birth to the young one, viviparous. Absolutely. And there is a sexually dimorphic kind. So mammalias are a highly developed category. So it's just they've got three subclasses here: Prototherian, Metatherian, and Eutherian. Prototherian, they are egg-laying mammals. So egg-laying mammals in the sense, see, this category is retaining the quality of reptilians and apes. So they lay eggs, very primitive type of mammals. The next category is Metatherian. They've got a pouch, and marsupials, kangaroo kind. And the last one is Eutherian, truly placental mammals, and the baby is fully developed in, and they deliver the baby. So this is highly developed. When compared to this Porifera, primitive, to this, we have been trailing all the way in evolution. This, with all the category of this symmetry, coelom, and the cell aggregation, and with all that, they classified animal kingdom like this. And if you have any other doubt, you please put it in the comment section, and share and subscribe. Thank you.